Okay, so there's the historical, social, and cultural background to the film, Kat. So the purpose of this video is for you to understand a little bit of what led up to the film being made and the topics that relate to it, and also to give you a bit of an indication so that then you can make a judgment on what impact it had in the modern world. And this is sort of how you achieve very strong marks in a text response by talking about the context, authorial intent, and authorial style. So with that in mind, what you're looking for are proper nouns, so capital letters, for organizations and for famous people, and also dates. So as you flick through, if something catches your eye, you probably need to write down the date or the names, and think about how you might be able to link that into a piece of essay writing you do on the film category. So the first thing we're going to talk about is Erik Jensen's scholarly article, the title of which is right behind me. And the article basically found that there were two very distinct discourses, which is basically people discussing a topic and different ideas, basically different opinions would be a good synonym. But he found that the debate was very thin rather than thick, meaning that it wasn't as well developed and that people had very sort of simplistic and basic ideas in regards to the topic. But within that dialogue, he found two distinct parts. So the first is in the public news media, so sort of newspapers, TV and that sort of thing, the way it was reported was very positive and very future-focused. So, it could solve all of our problems and it could fix everything that's wrong with the world. By contrast, all of the films it looked at had the exact opposite. So the films were mostly focused on sort of the Frankenstein-type idea where science runs out of control and the type of technology being looked at, namely cloning, is taken to its nth degree or to the ultimate conclusion, and the results are bad, dramatically violent, or something similar. So what you need to think about is, how does Gattaca fit within this very thin discourse? So is it more towards the negative or more towards the positive side? Also, within his article, he noted the Wellcome Trust. They did a study on cloning and they had people discussing it, and they found that quite often people referred to popular media, namely films, in their discussion of it, which is another indication of the way that the discourse around cloning is actually quite simplistic. So, if you're discussing cloning and your knowledge is limited to, say, the film Gattaca or a similar film on cloning, then that probably indicates you don't have a very strong knowledge base on cloning itself. And this fact also indicates that films have quite a strong effect on the zeitgeist or the understanding of the people of the time. So you can implicate from that that the film Gattaca, due to its popularity, had quite an impact on the public opinion in regards to cloning. So your decision is, what kind of effect was that it had on the public? Was it positive? Was it negative? Did it shine a positive light on cloning or a negative light? So a concept you might be able to refer to in an essay is what's known as the Frankenstein myth, or alternatively something different, which is the domino fallacy. So the Frankenstein myth is basically that science is kind of led by slightly fringe, crazy type characters, scientists typically, who kind of pursue their ideas into areas that we as sort of normal, thoughtful human beings would not do if we were in charge, I guess. So it sort of sets up scientists as removed and separate from human nature, or separate from the majority of popular opinion. And it shows that the things that they produce are often quite problematic. The domino fallacy is basically a flaw in logic. And the domino fallacy just is the opinion that if you start something, it will not stop. So a simple example of the domino fallacy is same-sex marriage, where people use the argument that if same-sex marriage was legalized, which it is now, that would then lead to polygamy, that would then lead to people marrying animals, and so forth. So in this sense, the domino fallacy is that once you start cloning, you won't be able to stop, and there'll be no rules put in place to stop it. Of course, history would show that policy will be put in place and things will be controlled, but the domino fallacy presumes that these things will never take place and that this is a problem. But another core concept is successful films and the zeitgeist. So zeitgeist is basically the thoughts or opinion of an entire group or generation. And the concept we're discussing here is that films are meant to tap into a zeitgeist, so they are actually the popular opinion has a certain feeling about something, or it has a certain idea that's sort of troubling or circulating within a community, and then a film that taps into that is one that will therefore be a success. So people typically use the example of zombies. So when zombie films were very popular, and there are two quite distinct periods that you could look at if you want to about when zombie movies were popular, but like the more recent zombie explosion of films, where there were quite a few around in a short space of time, people use that to indicate that is sort of a discussion on mindlessness and sort of mindless consumerism, and the zombies represent the people in the society, which is us, and the way we mindlessly follow and mindlessly do things. So your job is to consider Gattaca was very successful at the time and it tapped into the zeitgeist, and your job is to decide what the popular opinion or the popular idea that it was tapping into, the kind of maybe even a fear within the society that it was drawing upon.